going to talk about the lymphatic system, beginning with the lymphatic capillaries, because this is where lymph enters for the first time. We will then talk about the collecting lymphatic vessels, then a lymph node, then the lymphatic trunks, and then the lymphatic ducts. So we'll talk about these vessels in the order that lymph travels from the tissue site back to the cardiovascular system. Now, lymphatic capillaries are where that fluid, that excess fluid that leaked out of the cardiovascular system into the tissue, is reabsorbed into the lymphatic system. Those blind-ended capillaries. Now, lymphatic capillaries are always described as being highly permeable. Compared to blood capillaries, they are more permeable than even the most permeable blood capillary. That means that fluid, cells even, so a bacterium, which is a cell, of course, a virus, other molecules that are hanging out in the connective tissue, can easily pass through that permeable wall of the lymphatic capillary. Endothelial cells overlap, which creates this sort of incomplete endothelium. And those overlapping endothelial cells create this flap-like mini valve, which sort of open and close and allow that fluid to enter the lymphatic capillary. As I've said, once that fluid enters into the lymphatic capillary, it is called lymph. Now, lymphatic capillaries are located almost everywhere there are blood capillaries, except for bone tissue, teeth, the bone marrow, and then the central nervous system. So the function of lymphatic capillaries is to take up that excess fluid via this very permeable, incomplete endothelial wall with overlapping cells that draw in that excess fluid. That fluid is then called lymph.